somebody in the head. We don't hit excessively hard and break my swords, right, gentlemen? Right. Okay.
Adam.
So, this is made of fur. Every one of them's different. They all have different densities. The object is to reach out and touch somebody. If you get touched, you acknowledge it. You say good, whatever. You don't say I got you, because that's not a good thing. That's cowboys and captains, and Civil War and stuff like that. We don't want to do that. If I say stop, it means that's an administrative stop, because we're going to do something else. We're going to critique or do something. If I say hold, that's an SCA thing, which means stop what you're doing right now and look around. You don't have to drop to one knee, but basically stop. And if you hear the word hold yelled out, you also echo that. So if I say hold, everybody says hold. If one of you sees something unsafe, like someone's on the ground and you got your foot on their throat, you might go hold, and we all look around and go hold, and we'll come see what's going on. Okay? So that's safety. Hands are not targets, heads are not targets. Hit somebody in the head, you die. So if you hurt somebody, you stay with them until they stop crying. Basic stuff. Okay, this is a long knife, right? Real long knife. And this is your shield, your scabbard. And it sits on your shoulder. Okay, it doesn't go across the front of your body. It sits up here like this. Okay, as soon as your shield gets across the front of your body, you're gonna get hurt because they're gonna be pushing on it. This part of your shield is a weapon. You can hit somebody with it, okay? Try punching with the front edge of your shield. Okay, just the front edge, like you're gonna hit somebody with a left. And if you put your hip into it, you can knock them over. The rest of your shield is for protection. You don't wanna do that, why?
You can't see anything.
You're blind, right? You can't see. So your shield stays here, and you'll block more with your sword. Okay, you'll block more with your sword. Now, by and large, as far as I can tell, they didn't do a whole lot of edge-to-edge hitting. Swords that they found, swords I've seen in Europe on the pictures, they didn't have a whole lot of notches in the blade. You get a notch sword, you file it down, pretty soon you got a dagger. So we don't want to do that. What they would do, as far as I can think, is if someone strikes at you with an edge, which is what they're going to do, you turn your sword just slightly and take it on the bevel. Not flat, just take it on the edge on the bevel. What else? The other thing that we don't do is play Hollywood. This is Hollywood. Okay, what happens when this happens? Right? I grab her and hit her right across there. Or I pat her on the face. Or she drops her shield. And I'm doing something else and she hits me someplace with her fist. Or grabs my wrist and shoves me out of the way. So you want to keep measure. Okay, Adam is perfectly safe. He's still perfectly safe. Unless he sees my feet start to move, and if he knows my right foot is out, I have to lean, and he can just step back. That's your first defense, is get out of the way. Don't let him get you. We don't spend a whole lot of time doing this in Hollywood. Because the sword's not the target, and that's what breaks swords. The body is the target, so we won't hear much of that. You're looking for an opening where you can get them. With a big old shield up there, it's real hard, especially since you're not going for the head. But you've got hands, well, you've got forearms, shoulders, and legs. A whole lot of skeletons have been dug up with notches in their legs. They're getting cut underneath. Okay, put your shields down behind you. And five and five, and what you're going to do is you're going to have a long knife fight. Okay?
Quick question. Are these thrusting weapons?
Yeah.
Great.
They are.
Do you want to spread the line?
Pardon?
Spread out.
Yeah, spread out. Thank you.
You're kind of the edge.
And what you're going to do, it would pay this when you get close enough to someone, you're going to introduce yourself by saying your name.
I have a
spin. Okay. So
that I've got for 50.
Okay. And that's kind of an introduction. Well, that way we also learn each other.
Take a,
this is kind of a cool thing that someone introduced to us. And it was actually
down at Boston.
All right, long knife fight. I basically keep my hand across here because I don't care about that bone that much. So I can use that kind of in my elbows here if I need it. My hand's in front of my sternum. My left foot is out. And I'm kind of like that. I can step forward and thrust. I can step forward and cut over my head. Over the head cut, start with the sword somewhere up here. Just bring it up, bend your elbow, scratch your back. Over the top of your head, step out and strike on the offensive side. It's better to step. It can be a half step, or you can start with your left foot out. Go that way. That takes money offside. Like I said, scratch your back, go over the top of your head, don't hit yourself in the head, and strike that way. Be careful of that particular thing because you could hit someone in the head beside yourself. Ready? Ready. Engage.
Them,
not playing
that
playing
bang
bang.
You
set?
Yep.
Michael. No.
And stop. Nice roll. Okay. Emily, would you go down the end of the line and everyone step down one this way?